Faculty aren't simply your teachers. They can be your mentors, your study aides, your employers. Faculty are here to help students. That's the job. But in order for us to help you, you gotta talk to us. So we sat down with a few students and faculty members to discuss some strategies for approaching, communicating with, and working with faculty members. Why is it important for students at a large university to have mentors?
Every student needs to have some type of a touch point, a touchstone, someone that he or she can go to and help puzzle through the important academic issues in his or her life. College is such a time of growth, and that growth needs to happen not just between students, but really between the student and the faculty member. And that should really ideally happen during some one-on-one time.
That moment when you're actually engaging faculty can be a challenge. So what are some good ways that students can engage with faculty and start to develop that mentoring relationship?
I think that the way that faculty can really be approached is through the materials. You mm-hmm. have the materials of an entire class, and there's going to be something that's really going to draw you in. I think coming prepared into office hours mm-hmm. with that question is a terrific thing. Making sure that if the faculty member offers you different readings or different options or things to explore, that you take the time to do that, to do some of those readings or perhaps to research that fellowship, mm-hmm. and then email back and say, thank you so much for spending that time with me. I found that article really fascinating. It's not a good idea, even if you are hoping to bring up your grade, mm-hmm. to go to office hours simply to say, I want to figure out how to improve my grade.
Yes.
While that might be a part of a student's primary motivation, it's much more compelling for the professor to think that he or she wants to actually engage in some of the substantive material of the class.
Mm-hmm. Talking to faculty can, for some people, be very intimidating. And maybe it's different than how you would talk to someone, a new friend that you might meet at the university. So what are some ways that they can sort of cross that threshold? How should they be approaching faculty?
So certainly the way in which a student is going to introduce him or herself, either in person or over email, is very important. You should always use someone's title unless they invite you to use their first name. Mm-hmm. So at a university, professor or mm-hmm. doctor so-and-so is usually going to be what you should say. If you are sending an email, you should always have some type of a greeting there. Mm-hmm. Dear professor or doctor so-and-so. should always sign the email with your name. Never say hey. Don't address someone by their first name. Mm-hmm. Don't leave the salutation blank, for example. And again, always try and connect around an idea. Have something that you want to actually discuss as opposed to, I'm interested in getting to know you, mm-hmm. I'm just interested in the class. Yes. You want to talk about something specific.
Yeah. What are some misconceptions that you hear from some students that you work with about faculty and approaching faculty?
I think the first one, the major one, is the hierarchy. They think the professors are too high to reach because of experience and expertise. Mm-hmm. And actually, professors, most of them are really willing to listen, mm-hmm. and everybody can bring something to the table.
I was wondering if you'd talk a little bit about some of the benefits that you've seen in yourself working with a mentor.
So my mentor is actually my professor of medical anthropology. I took her course and I was very impressionable mm-hmm. In a way that a lot of the works I produced for the class, I included illustrations, and she took notice and asked me one day, Jan, it would be really neat if we were able to work together on an illustration project, mm-hmm. Like a children's novel. And I thought, that would be great. A couple years later, she phoned me, mm-hmm. to my surprise, and asked me, I have this project, and mm-hmm. I wonder if you're very interested in tackling it with me. And mm-hmm. I thought, this is perfect. Mm-hmm. And we were able to start on this pilot for a public health campaign for women in Mozambique.
Oh, that's wonderful. That's wonderful. Faculty are here to help you. If you're interested in the course content, if you need help with the course content, reach out to a faculty member. A discussion with a faculty member can often point you in a really interesting direction.